Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. If you are new to the channel, welcome. This is Richard from WELSHYTECH, and today we are reviewing the Peerless Assassin 120 Digital in Black. How does this perform, and should you buy it? Let's find out, shall we? Hey, so we're back with another product from Thermalright. This time it's the Peerless Assassin 120 Digital in Black. So let's unbox this and take a look at it, shall we? Of course, it does come with the user manual. This will actually tell you how to install it for AMD as well as Intel. And then we got the actual cooler itself. First, we go to the fans. Very standard generic fans that they normally just produce. But that's fine. Another, the same one again. Exactly the same. These are the TLC12CX28V2s. Oh, so they're 28 mils, then. Are they in thickness? Wow, hey, that's quite thick. That's what comes in the accessory package now. It does come with all the standoffs you need for Intel as well as AMD. It does come with a splitter for the fan. And yes, it does come with thermal paste. I get this comment all the time on specifically Thermalright products. All of them come with thermal paste. So there you know. Then we got the cooler itself, and I will be back. Okay, so as you can see, there's the screen, very large screen. Yes, it is magnetic, just like that. The screen is magnetic, like I said. Now, this does have rather thick heat pipes. This has 6 heat pipes with a massive base by there, and the fins are very thin. Now, as for like the specs and stuff, obviously there's the connector there. Now, as for specs of this specific one, hold on. Okay, so the model is, of course, the Peerless Assassin Digital. The dimensions are 125 by 110 and 162. That's rather tall for a heatsink. Now, the support on the motherboards is LJ1851, 1700, 11.5X, 1200, AM5, and AM4. Now, as for the specs specifically, now, the fan dimensions, of course, are 120 by 120 by 28, so they are thicker than normal fans. The range of, the highest they go is only 1850 RPM. The noise decibel rating for this is at 29.5 decibels with a CFM of 88.89. Wow. The start pressure is 2.21 millimeter H2O with a 4-pin connector and the rated 0.3 amp with a SFDB bearing. Now, as for the screen, okay, so they don't actually list anything on the box, but what I'll do is once I get into the overall software and show you what it's like, we will get to the overall screen because that is the overall size of the screen. I'd say this is a, I don't know, it looks more like maybe a 3-inch, maybe 4-inch screen, so, and it's probably going to be an LCD screen. So let's get some test bench. Okay, then, so as for the installation part of the video, now you are going to need these 4 standoffs, and they are just going to go like this, that, and just like that. Easy. Now, as for these, as you can see there, it says AM4. Well, that is how they actually go in, this way. So, pointing that way. What you do is take the screws, put them down like this. Preferably have a magnet screwdriver, make life a lot easier. And that's it for one side. Now, the other side's the exact opposite, just like this. Okay, and that's for the standoffs. Now, as for thermal paste, this is the thermal paste I use. This is Polymer Therm X10. And obviously, application is going to vary on how you like it or preferences, pretty much. But me, as long as it gets good amount in the middle, it should spread easier. Now, as for putting the cooler on, it's quite simple. So, easy, just like this. Now, I would suggest lining it up as well. Make sure that the bottom of the threads are touching. I'm going to put that both sides. That. This one, you want to make sure that you actually have a very long screwdriver. It's a lot easier this time around. So you want to screw one side, just like this. Like that. Basically until it bottoms out. And that's done. Now, as for the screen, of course, this does obviously just magnet on, like just like that. But as for the cable, let's show you how to do the cable. So as you can see, there's the USB headers. Now I've already got this installed in one, but just take this out, and that is the connector. So USB on it, and then you want one header that says USB. And all you do is plug it in, and that's pretty much it for the USB 2 cable. Okay, so as for the software for the TRCC, the only really things you can actually change, primarily, you don't have to actually connect any of these. You don't have to select any of them. But actually, yes, you do. You have to select one. As for like customization, you can't really change much except for the color when it comes to the RGB. You can have CPU temperatures, the GPU temp, the percentage of the CPU load, and GPU load as well. And pretty much the only thing you can really do is just change the colors, which I don't really see the point. Me personally, I don't like screens on CPU coolers because I don't see the actual point. But of course, people are going to like it otherwise because of the overall design and look. But this is pretty much it. All you can change, you can basically just select the Celsius of the CPU, the load of the GPU, the basically just temperatures on the load of CPU and GPU. That's it. And then you can just change for the colors, which you can just change it to RGB, monochrome breathe, which will just change colors that way. There's monochrome, there's color cycle, just change colors. And then obviously there's rainbow. But that's pretty much it for the software. It's very basic and very easy to use, but personally I find it useless. This is the Peerless Assassin 120 Digital. This is the fans at 50% fan speed. Very quiet at 50%. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. It's quite loud at 100%. Okay, so as for the system being used for testing, it is my AM5 platform. It's a Ryzen 9 7900 with PBO enabled with 32 gigs of DDR5. It's also a B650 motherboard with an RX 7800 XT Nitro, and it has a 1000 watt cooling power supply, and it's housed in the B-Quad Shadowbase 800FX. Okay, so as for the room temperature, now the room at before testing was 16 Celsius, but did go up to 22 Celsius after testing. Now, two different types of tests, 50 and 100% fan speed. So here we go for 50% fan speed. The CPU power was 167 watts with a low 154. The CPU clocks were a high at 5.4 with a low at 5 gigahertz. Now, as for CPU, specifically an instruction set, that's what Cinebench is. The idles were 35 with a max of 89 Celsius. Blender Pavilion idles 35 with a max of 88. Blender Classroom idles 35 with a max of 87. And 3D Mark Super Test, the idles were 35 with a max of 84 Celsius. Okay, so for 100% fan speed. Now, this time the CPU power draw at high was 166 watts with a low at 154. The CPU clocks were actually a tad higher at 5.4 with a low at 5.1. So you gain 100 megahertz there for performance. Now, as for the temperatures, the idles for Cinebench R23 were idle at 36 Celsius with a max of 86, so the temps have already come down. Blender Pavilion idles 36 with a max of 85. Blender Classroom idles 36 with a max of 85. And 3D Mark Super Test, the idle 36 with a max of 78 Celsius. Now, how does it compare to other CPU coolers on the market? Well, what I'm going to do is pull actually a few air coolers I've got here. I haven't done many dual towers with screens, but the ones I've done and other dual towers, I will be putting in a graph, which will show up just after what I've just said. So make sure you continue to watch, because I will show you some actual data to show you how this does compare to other coolers, especially big ones on the market currently. Okay, then. So what do you think? Now, what I'm going to really say is that for this cooler, it's £46 or £47 on Amazon currently. Now, the white one, of course, is going to be a little bit higher because white products do generally cost a little bit more. Now, whether you should buy this or the original Assassin, look, I'm going to be completely honest with you. Unless you want the screen, the original Peerless Assassin still performs amazing on AM4 and AM5. So, unless you really want the specifically the big screen, then this is definitely a good buy for you. But if you don't care about the screen, then the original Peerless Assassin or even the Phantom Spirit 120 Evo would still do as good or better than this specific one. Now, yes, this is a little bit lower when it comes to temps from like the ones from DeepCool. Yes, they are. But DeepCool also charge a bit more. Now, yes, this is a nearly £50. It's rather expensive considering how much the original Peerless Assassin costs, which sometimes is lower than £25. Now, whether you want to buy this one or not, that's up to you. I will leave links actually to the Thermalright link for Amazon specifically, so you can have a look through all the different air coolers. Now, if you don't care about the screen, then get the original Peerless Assassin or get a Phantom Spirit 120 Evo. But if you do care about the screen, then yes, it's definitely a good option. But I'm not here to tell you to buy it or not to buy it. I'm just going to tell you if you do, I've got links down below. Now, as for what else is coming, now I've got absolute tons of stuff coming. CPU, I've got an Intel CPU here. I've got a motherboard coming now either tomorrow or Friday. I've got another AM5 motherboard here. The 9060 XT graphics card review, that should be next week. I'm really trying to test everything as possible. I've got absolute tons of stuff here. AIOs, mice. I've got a camera. I've got a streaming camera. I've got absolute tons of stuff coming. So make sure you subscribe. And as always, I hope you've got a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. This is Richard for WELSHYTECH. Good. Bye.